Thank you to you, Pravin. First of all, thank you to the STEM organization for this meeting, which organized in not easy time, difficult time of coronavirus spread and diseases and so on. And you take this job and made it very good. Thank you for management of the Ariel University, which agreed to give the roof for this event, and especially for Professor Ben Pinchasov and all people which were involved in this. And this is my presentation, which is named application of capacity reactive power to stabilize the voltage in distribution line, especially with massive introduction of PV power plants. We know the trend of the use of the renewable energy is going up during all the last time, and we assume that it will be continued further. And two big electricity production sources are for usage, wind and solar. The competition between two of these renewables electricity productions is going from the last 20, 30 years, and the main competitor will be, and main the winner will be the sources which will give the lowest price of electricity. If you'll see the trends of electricity cost during last time, we can see that all of these sources give the increase of the of this cost. However, the PV solar production is the let's say the biggest decreasing rate during the time. And now, two of the sources, wind and solar PV, is achieving the price of 5 cents per kilowatt hour. That is much lower than in conventional solar, in conventional power plants. Therefore, if you see the trends, we can consume during next decades, solar PV will be the most preferable renewable electricity production. In Israel, the electricity PV and solar production began not many years ago, but today it get the acceleration rate, and we can see different solar PV plants, which you can see here in the desert, and one thermosolar 2 megawatts of power thermosolar, Ashalim. This is in Negev district of Israel, and here in the map we can see the preferable paths, location of the solar plants, and we can assume that the solar electric production will grow up. We can see here the statistics of the cumulative PV power during the time in Israel, and we can see that now, especially during last years, we achieved tremendous, relatively big, meanwhile not tremendous, the solar production is assumed as a cumulative power 2.7 gigawatts of the power. And we are going now to, in the next decade, to achieve up to the 20, even 30% of the total electricity requirements, which will be covered by the solar electricity. Technical advantages and challenges related to widespread of use of solar electricity. Of course, this electricity is environmentally friendly and no pollution. And together with this, we decrease the use of the fossil fuel. It's very important thing. Not less important that cost is going down all time, and during the next decade we will get the prices of solar electricity lower than in any of unconventional plants. However, not only advantages brings solar electricity. There are some technical problems connected with the use of solar electricity production. Well, first, the relatively low energy density per unit area, especially with the countries with density of population, such as Israel, for example. The second, instability of power production is during day, hours, and seasons. Technical problems of frequently controlling closed power grids, such as Israel, which is big island of solar of electrical industry, big but island. And the last, the deviation of voltages in distribution lines having massive PV installation. We concentrate our thought on the last problem, because if the first problems, theory first problem, will appear or are appearing when the percent of this production, PV production, will going up to over the 10-15%, the last problem appears immediately when we have installation in distribution grids, PV plants. And here we can see the equivalent circuit of the electrical system. First of all, equivalent power system, which includes power, big power plants, which produce electricity due the main lines in Israel, mainly with the voltage 161 kilovolts. After this, substation, which decreases the voltage up to 33 or 22 kilovolts. And after this, the distribution line to the end consumers, part of them are own solar plants, begins from some kilowatts of power and up to the 1-2 megawatts of power. In this plan, in this circuit, we can see that at the end consumers, we get the voltage, which must be nominal and cannot deviate over permissible levels. However, the distribution transformation, which are responsible for the keeping the voltage inside permissible level, have tap changer, which change the transformation ratio depending on the consumer of the electricity, and this way they try to keep the voltage on the nominal level. However, these devices are have a sluggish dynamic response, and if we have here stochastic electricity solar power plants, the problem begins difficult. For example, we can represent here the statistics data of the voltage distribution in the line which have 20 megawatts of the nominal power and 4 megawatts of the installed electricity production. And we can see here.
Dr. Averbuch, can you put it in full screen mode, please? Because it's difficult to see.
It's better?
No, full screen mode. It's
Okay.
see the downward. Yeah.
It's okay?
Yes.
Good, very good, very yeah. good.
Thank you, thank you.
That, yes, yes, okay. Thank you too for your comment. So we can see that the voltage events, especially voltage rise over permissible level, which is determined as 10% minus 10 plus 10% due to the presence of massive presence of TV station is significant. During the date hour, we too see the picture and the graph that the voltage doesn't remain constant instead of the presence of the special devices that I said, tap changer in the distribution transformers. Here the another graphs of statistics showing the different events of the instability of voltage instability, and we can see that voltage instability in during the year can be accounted of tens of seconds. If you will take into consideration that voltage instabilities, especially voltage swells, can cause to the fault of the equipment, different sensitive equipment, it's very very calm situation. Here we can see the statistic and the graph of the voltage tap changer, which is responsible for voltage stability. You can see that response time is very slow. It takes tens even more close to 2 minutes to return the voltage to the nominal level. This is when we have voltage rise, and we can see that the voltage drop, how it is compensated. Together with this, we can say that electricity production of PV plants are very stochastic. During 1 second, only 1 second, in the concentration solar plants, the power can be changed plus minus 30% during 1 second only. Therefore, this sluggish response cannot be responsible for good keeping, for good control of the voltage. Can we can see here again that the assumed statistics show that 0.06% of time of the year time voltage overcome maximum level, and 0.1% of time is below minimum possible level. So it's not so applicable. It's not applicable quality of the electricity. Of course, it can cause, and we have statistics, it's influence the equipment and cause in many cases to the fault of the sensitive equipment. So what to do? There are some methods, and we choose as a possible solution of voltage to prevent voltage instabilities, applying reactive capacitance power. Why a capacitance reactive power? Because reactive power does not cause to the loss of electricity, relatively easy for implementation, and the relatively cheap solution. What are the objectives and tasks for implementation of the proposed method? Firstly, develop an equivalent circuit for a distribution line with PV station. Second, analytical expression of voltage and current magnitudes after applying a capacitive reactive power. Third, development of the algorithm of optimal applying capacitive power. And the fourth, dynamic reaction on capacitor's connection to the load. We can see here the equivalent electrical circuit of the distribution line, after distribution transformers, impedance of the line, impedance of the consumers, PV plants producing power, and the compensating capacitors connected to the load. Here we can analyze, more easily analyze the processes in this line by a simplified equivalent circuit, which much easier for analyzing. Assessment of voltage magnitude can be done by applying of the equation, which node equation, which describes the process in the line and the voltage of the load. The expression of the voltage amplification shows that the applying of the capacitance power can rise the voltage of the load. We can see here the graph which have maximum when we applied more and more big capacitors. We can see the rise of the voltage up to the maximum level, after which voltage begins to drop. Therefore, we can work only on the first part of this curve. However, we can see that the magnification effect can be significant. Optimal value of capacitance. Therefore, when we see that the voltage can rise, but the capacitance has been chosen in the optimal manner. Therefore, we must select the capacitor which will produce magnification effect, needed magnification effect. And this analytical expression gives us this possibility. The possible amplification effect of the load, in principle, can be done due to the reactance of the distribution line. And the more reactance of distribution line relative to the impedance of the load, the bigger magnification effect, amplification effect can be achieved. Required value of capacitance, as I said previously, can be chosen by the next analytical expressions. This was positive part of the this method of capacitors power. However, this is negative part. Together with the voltage rise is growing the line current. So it's not so good. It's not so good because bigger current can cause additional losses in distribution line and in the distribution transformer. However, we can apply this method to taking into consideration that this increase of the current can be significant. However, we can apply this method for some tens of seconds until the tap changer will return the voltage to its nominal value. So it's a temporary method which can be applied in the intermittent processes when we have voltage events. Comparison between voltage modification and the current increase, we can see here. So the voltage increase is escorted with the current increase. However, it can be less if near the consumers are PV power installations. How we can apply this method technically? There are some devices today, electronic, but of them are electronic devices, can produce capacitive power. However, we choose another way, which use the bank of capacitors, can be switched due to the need. Capacitors can be chosen in the binary manner. The first is the smallest, and after this, each other is going to in the power of two, and the special triac switches can apply the needed capacitors. Taking into account that there is switching, we have to accurately assume, analyze the dynamic processes, which is escorting the switching process. This analytical solution was developed, analytical solution of the behavior, current and voltage behavior, and was found in which range of parameters produce for us applicable dynamic process. The was made for implementation this this algorithm simulational analysis was carried out on the PC model and was found that the results of simulation are very close to the analytical prediction. Here we can see the dynamic processes, especially when capacitors is connected to the load for compensation, and we can see that dynamic process relatively is applicable instead of having some transient process that can be in some case neglectable. Experimental results for testing the method, we built the experimental test results in the laboratory and provided different capacitance connected to the load, which was simulated. We simulated the distribution line and simulated consumers, of course, on the scale of some kilowatts only. Compare the results of analytical expression with experimental results, which show good agreement between them. This is for voltage, previously was for current, and this is for voltage. The current change during the voltage change shows again this agreement. However, again, we can see that the voltage increase is escorted by the voltage, by the current increase. Here, this experimental verification of the dynamic processes, we can see that if we use the control, the appropriate control of the switching, we can get applicable dynamic process. Results and conclusion. The efficient solution solution presented to the problem of voltage instability in the power distribution lines. Application of capacitance power to the load can effectively prevent voltage declination during load powering. The required rise of a voltage can be provided by connected to the load appropriate capacitor, which capacitance should be selected in accordance with the impedance of a distribution line and necessary voltage increase. The set of capacitors for simplicity of control system structure should be chosen in a binary manner, which each sequence of capacitance is 2 times bigger than the previous one. The substantial current increase in the distribution line during the capacitive power application to the load should be taken into account. Therefore, a significant voltage increase can be obtained for a relatively short time, only during which a tap changer in the distribution transformer will be able to correct the transformation ratio and to keep voltage in the nominal to the nominal to bring voltage to the nominal level. A dynamic process of voltage distortion when capacitors are being connected can be smoothed significantly in the, if the connection to the load will be carried out at the end or beginning of the voltage period. Important to remark that such connection control should be easily carried out by a thruster that after switching on and off, start stop current flow automatically. That's all. Thank you for your attention. And thank you for organizer again of this event and for Mr. Pravin, for Professor Pravin, for his tremendous effort in this difficult time to bring together scientists from all over the world. Thank you.